Hello everyone, welcome back to the second part of this video series where we are trying to build a mobile app for kids' stories. If you haven't watched first part of this video series, then I suggest you give it a look. I'll leave the link in the description of this video. So today in this second part, we'll be building the tech side of the app using FlutterFlow. As you can see, it's a no-code development app, so you can create with less possible code a good-looking apps with this features of the FlutterFlow. So now we will be creating a new project called Kid Stories, and then from here on you will see how to build a simple Kid Stories app. And I hope you will find this video useful. If you find it useful, please give it a like, subscribe to our channel and share it with your friends. And keep watching and let me know in comments if you have any questions, because from here on the video will be completely about FlutterFlow and their features and some parts, and in some parts I ran into some errors as well, so you will see how to fix those errors. I tried to fixing it using custom codes, but then it didn't work out so well, so I created the same solution in a different way. So keep looking, keep watching this video and see if it helps you in any ways. So here I'm putting up a button in FlutterFlow. I have already created button in the image while creating this image in Canva, but that button is a directly into the picture. But we need a button where the user can click on it and go to the second screen where they can select stories. So for that purpose, I'm using a button. So this button is a sample button. So since our app is completely a sample app, so this button will be, I'll not decorate it too much, but it will look something similar to the existing one. And I think it will work pretty good. Let's see. Now this is a stories page where the user can select between multiple stories. Since we have only one story, so I'll just put one image. Again here I'll be putting a similar image or a random image on top of these existing images. Maybe I'll just put in one, maybe in the middle I'll put it a different image which when clicked by the user, it will bring them to the actual stories page, the stories that we have created in Canva. So just see how I built this one, and it will be similar to the existing images with similar properties. Okay, here we have created the actual story page where we will be using the carousel from Flutter. So we will be using carousel for displaying different images, not actual images, the video files that we generated for this story. So in place of images, we will put video player here, and then we will stop the automated loop of this carousel and then make some other settings so that it works according to our plan. Now we have almost everything that we need, the three pages, the main pages of the app, and everything is, I think, working perfectly right so far. But now I want a specific functionality where at the last page of the app, of the carousel that we created, I want, like, for it, the last screen of the carousel to finish and then go back to the story selection page by itself. So this feature is kind of a custom feature. So I'll try to achieve this by writing a custom code, as you can see. And the good thing is FlutterFlow also has a AI code assistant, which I'll try. If it works, it works. Else I'll write the code myself. This is a very particular functionality and I hope it works. And it's not necessary because we already have a return button on the last screen as well, so the user can click on the return button and go back to the story selection page. But this is just an extra add-on that I think will be good for UI. So let's see if it's going to work it out, and let's see if it will work. I'm not sure. I think it will. I mean, it could work on an Android Studio if I was creating just using Flutter, but with FlutterFlow it's a little bit different because they have a different, I think they are using different sets of libraries. So I'll give it a try, and if it works, it works. Else I'll use some other way. Let's see. So here I'll try to test this app so far with the custom code that I created. For some reason the test feature is not working on my browser. I don't know. And it also shows some errors in the code. So I'll go back and I'll fix all the errors, whatever the possible errors, and I'll try to run the app. Instead of testing, I'll run the app because testing feature is not working on my browser for some reason. Let's see how it goes. So I tried using custom quotes, but like I expected earlier, when I started working with FlutterFlow, I think FlutterFlow has a different set of libraries that they are using. So right now I'll delete this my custom code, and I'll simply use the action setup feature for the last video screen, and then I'll put some time delay, and once it gets hit it will directly go to the story selection page so that it will be easy for the users. It's just a UI feature that will be helpful for the users. And I think after that it will run pretty easy. Let's see. So as you can see, it's running nicely on browser now without any errors, and I hope it works as expected with all the proper timings and all the features. And in the last page I think it should work with a little bit of time delay. It will go back to the story selection page. And if it doesn't, then that's fine as well, because we also have a return button at the bottom right corner of this app. So once the story finishes and the user clicks, maybe after 2 seconds, it will automatically go back to the story selection page, else the user can click also the return button. So we have completed this app successfully, and I hope it has helped you as well. Do not forget to like and share this video.